So the point I'm trying to make here is that we have the internet, which is what Ethereum is trying to solve, and then we have money, which Bitcoin is trying to solve. Which one's more important? Okay. And the way I look at it is I think they're both foundationally attached to each other. I don't think one's more important than the other, but I do think that one's more valuable than the other. Okay. So just to make my case on Ethereum, there's so many other markets in the world. Gold is the closest thing to Bitcoin. And people have used gold in the past, thousands of years ago. People have used gold through, you know, since the beginning of mankind to hold as a store of wealth. People have used it and it played its role. But gold is non-transferable, and that's why dollars came. And then dollars came and basically backed the dollars by gold. And then they, you know, of course, they stopped backing the dollars by gold and controlled the monetary supply. But if you think of Bitcoin, it's basically a kind of like a combination of both, right? If you really think about it, it's more transferable than gold. It holds similar properties. Obviously, you can't buy a cup of coffee with it. I don't think anybody wants to buy coffee with you know, Bitcoin. But the point I'm trying to make here is that it does its purpose very well. And I don't think upgrading Bitcoin is the smartest thing to do. Okay. Obviously, I'm not a developer, but I don't think so. I think it serves its purpose because everybody knows what it is. It's cryptographically secure. And that's its purpose. That's its only purpose. I don't think upgrading Bitcoin for smart contract capability is a smart thing to do. I don't think that. I think it's actually way smarter if we just uphold the security as strong as we possibly can. Right. And maybe make energy more renewable or whatever the case is, like that 30%, maybe we exploit them for whatever reason and we make sure they pay up to damaging the environment. I don't think it's Bitcoin per se. I think we can have a lot of renewable energy. I think it's just people exploiting and taking advantage of their country, their coal, whatever their natural resource that they have, right, in China. So long story short, I think they can work in conjunction, but it's pretty obvious that Ethereum's, you know, going to flip Bitcoin. If we come over here, you could see that this is like kind of tracking the flipping of Ethereum to Bitcoin. You can see active addresses, 71%. There's way more active addresses on Ethereum than Bitcoin. You can see the transaction count, obviously way higher on Ethereum to Bitcoin. Transaction volume, way higher. Trading volume, way higher on Ethereum. It's pretty much beating Bitcoin in a lot of ways. And we recently got into like Google search term. As you can see here, Ethereum's catching up to Bitcoin in a lot of different ways. And like I just showed you from the beginning, right? Come over here, you could see that we never got back to its former glory. We never got back to, you know, 88% Bitcoin dominance or whatever the case is. We have a whole bunch of things. Let me give you the case, right? We have a whole bunch of Ethereum has so much functionality. It's unbelievable, right? But if we go to CoinGecko, let me just show you an example of this. The first one was obviously decentralized finance. As you can see, DeFi. DeFi has $128 billion. And if we go over to DeFi Pulse, you can see all of these different applications that are basically on the Ethereum blockchain that Bitcoin can be used with. Now, Bitcoin right now has wrapped BTC. It's not necessarily decentralized, it's a centralized solution, but they have other things coming out that could be a decentralized solution to getting Bitcoin and Ethereum. I think Bitcoin can be the store of value it's always meant to be, but I don't think anything more, right? But I also think that Ethereum can be a world currency. It can hold the bond market, which bond is way bigger.